Now let us see different microbial complexes of the bacteria found into the oral cavity. In 1998, Sukransky et al. Did study on 185 subjects, and in these subjects, a total number of samples which were extracted from these subjects were 13,261 samples were collected for noting down the different organisms and dividing them into different complexes. The bacteria were classified as primary colonizers and secondary colonizers with the help of DNA hybridization. The complex were given different colors based upon the danger sign in the danger sign in naval cords. These color complexes are based upon the danger sign of the naval cords. Color of microbial complexes. And these microbial complexes are divided. Microbial complexes are divided into different groups. Based on the frequency. With which each microorganism is detected in a cluster. Thus, there are 5 different microbial complexes for the oral cavity bacteria. The first complex is the purple. These two can be clubbed into one. This is the purple complex. This consists of actinomyces species. Strain A of aggregative bacter actinomycetum comitans is associated with this. Aggregative bacter odontolyticus and V. parvula. And the second complex is the yellow complex. The yellow complex consists of Streptococcus mitis, Oralis sanguis and other Streptococcus species. These two complexes are the primary colonizers. So, what consists of primary colonizers are the purple complex and yellow complex. These are the primary colonizers. Now, the secondary colonizers consist of bacteria in the green circle, in the orange one and in the red one. The bacteria in the green and orange circles are responsible for periodontal and non-periodontal infections. These bacteria are responsible for periodontal and non-periodontal infections. And bacteria in the red complex, these three bacteria are in the red complex, are the most dangerous bacteria, and they are responsible for bleeding on probing. These three complexes constitute the secondary colonizers. Secondary colonizers consist of green complex, which consists of the bacteria which are least dangerous, and the two most dangerous complexes are orange and red complex. These two are the bacteria in these two groups are the most dangerous ones. So now let us see one by one the different complex bacteria. Green microbial complex consists of Echinella corodens, C. gingivalis, C. sputigena and aggregative bacter actinomycetum comitans group A. The orange complex consists of Prevotella intermedia, Campylobacter and E. nodatum, Fusobacterium nucleatum and F. periodontium. The important bacteria to remember are Prevotella intermedia, Fusobacterium nucleatum and Campylobacter rectus. These three bacteria you should remember in this complex. The third complex is the smaller complex, the red complex, which is important for bleeding on probing. These are the bacteria which are responsible for bleeding on probing in periodontitis. The bacteria are Porphyromonas gingivalis, Tannerella furcytha, and Tryponema denticola. These three bacteria are very much important for bleeding and probing in the periodontitis. Now, let us see how these bacteria derive nutrition from the host. As we all know, host is very important source. Host is a very important source of nutrition to the bacteria. Very important source of nutrition to bacteria. Now, what happens is when primary colonizers come into the oral cavity, early colonizers or the primary colonizers like streptococci and actinomyces invades the oral cavity, they utilize the oxygen that is present in the oral cavity and decrease the redox potential, means the environment of the oral cavity becomes reducing. More acidic environment generates. These organisms favor, thus creates an anaerobic environment over which the anaerobes, the secondary colonizers, can survive. Apart from these streptococci and actinomyces produce metabolic products like lactic acid and formic acid over which the secondary colonizers Vilonella and Campylobacter rectus survive. These Vilonella and Campylobacter rectus produces protoheme and menadione, which are important for the survival of Porphyromonas gingivalis. Porphyromonas gingivalis is a bacteria of red complex and a very important bacteria for causing periodontitis. This bacteria receives nutrition from the metabolic products like menadione and protoheme, which is produced by Campylobacter rectus, and menadione, which is produced by Vilonella. Apart from these two metabolic products, P. gingivalis also uses the heme, which is present in the hemoglobin of the host. The hemoglobin of the host consists of heme ion, and this heme ion is utilized by Porphyromonas gingivalis to grow and to exhibit its effect onto the periodontium. Also, the steroid hormone which is present into the host provides nourishment to Prevotella intermedia. It has been seen in various cases that the level of Prevotella intermedia increase is associated with increase in the level of steroids in the host. These two bacteria, Prevotella intermedia and Porphyromonas gingivalis, what they do is they produce isobutyrate. This isobutyrate is the metabolic product of P. gingivalis and Prevotella intermedia, which provides nourishment to Tryponema denticola, which is also a bacteria of red complex. This isobutyrate provides nourishment to Tryponema. Also, Tryponema gets its nourishment from the host through alpha globulin. Alpha globulins provide nourishment to Tryponema. Thus, three important proteins of host, which are hemoglobin or heme protein, globulin, alpha globulin protein, and steroid hormone from the host provide nourishment to the bacteria, to P. gingivalis, to Tryponema, and to Prevotella intermedia. Very frequently MCQs from this portion is asked. Now, Tryponema produces succinate, and this succinate is also produced by Capnocytophaga bacteria, which is also a great nutrient source to P. gingivalis and Prevotella intermedia. Now, this is the diagram which is simplified here, and you can remember it and see what are the different metabolic products which help in the growth of secondary colonizers into the oral cavity. Now, let us see some of the very important functions of biofilm. Biofilm tries to save the bacteria present inside it. Biofilm provides a very protected environment for the bacteria, protected environment for the bacteria present inside the biofilm. Now, let us take an example. Suppose the host has taken a medicine like penicillin. What will happen is, inside this is the biofilm, and inside this there are certain signaling molecules and many bacteria. what will happen is when the host is taken an antibiotic like penicillin, one of the bacteria inside the biofilm will be signaled ke one some danger is there. One bacteria is signaled that there is a danger. So what will happen is this bacteria will release certain molecules are secreted by the bacteria, which will signal the other bacteria into the biofilm. These molecules will signal other bacteria in biofilm that a danger has arrived, and these bacteria will try to combat that danger. These bacteria will try to fight that danger. How this will be done is these signaling compounds will make changes into the genetic material of these bacteria, and they will produce certain enzymes like beta lactamases. And as we all know, beta lactamase producing bacteria are resistant to penicillin. Thus, the growth of such bacteria will increase because of the production of these signaling molecules. Also, apart from this, there will be activation of certain efflux pumps, which are normally blocked by certain receptors. These pumps will be activated. These pumps, efflux pumps, or multi-drug resistant pumps. Efflux pumps or multi-drug resistant pumps will be activated. These will be activated, and these will secrete the antibiotic outside the biofilm. They will not allow the antibiotic to enter the biofilm. Thus, this is the mechanism how the biofilm tries to protect the bacteria inside the biofilm. So, bacteria are more resistant to drugs in biofilm. This point says what we have already explained. In the biofilm, the bacteria require more amount of antibiotics to be decreased. So, the quantity of drug that is required to decrease the amount of bacteria is more inside the biofilm. Also, the growth rate of the bacteria in the biofilm is very slow. The most of the antibiotics are ineffective in biofilm, but based on some researches, the antibiotics which are very much useful and which can act on the biofilm bacteria are macrolides. Macrolide antibiotics are azithromycin, erythromycin, clindamycin, etc. These are the drugs which can enter the biofilm and can hinder the growth of harmful bacteria. So these are the important points which you have to remember, and these can be asked even in MCQs. Let us discuss few questions regarding this topic. The first question is, in a biofilm, bacteria communicate with each other through. Option number one is co-aggregation. As we all know, co-aggregation is a method of cell-to-cell interaction, and in this the cells attach with each other through the help of receptors. So it is not a method of communication, it is an interaction between the receptors of different types of bacteria. Second is conch formation is a type of co-aggregation, and it is not a method of communication. Third option, we will come to third option afterwards. The fourth option is quorum sensing is a cell-to-cell signaling pathway. In this, as we have already seen, if any of the dangerous molecules or antibiotics are attacked into the biofilm, one of the bacteria senses the danger and it releases certain molecules, and these molecules form a part of cell signaling. These signals the other cells that there is a danger, and thus many processes like efflux pumps and anti-resistant bacteria develop into the biofilm. Thus, this process is known as quorum sensing. Quorum sensing is a method of cell-to-cell signaling. The third option, which is quorum quenching, is a method which inhibits the quorum sensing. Quorum quenching is the method which inhibits quorum sensing, or it inhibits the cell-to-cell signaling. So, the answer to this question is quorum sensing. Next question is, Structures resembling corn cob can be seen in how many days? Structures resembling corn cob in plaque can be seen in how many days? The options are 1 week, no. 2 week, no. 3rd week, yes. Structures resembling corn cob formation are seen in the plaque at 3 weeks. So this is the answer to this question.